Duikers. There's mating, there's lovers in the air. They're now running away, but there was a Duiker on top of another Duiker right there. They've just trotted behind the bush. They're just behind the quarries. You can see them moving. There, look, you see they're mating, look. Like I say, love is in the air. We had mating leopards yesterday, mating Duikers. Far less aggressive, the Duikers, than what the leopards are. And this is the only reason we're probably seeing them. Look, he's going to try and jump on her again. So male at the back, there we go. Oh, no, she's not having any of it at this stage. She's decided she's shy. She doesn't want us to be seen on camera. This is not the way she wants to grow up and spend her life as a woman. She does not want to be shamed by the world. So she's going into the thicket for some privacy. Exactly, as Lou says, imagine if her mom saw this. Well, Lou, I think her mom would be a little on the embarrassed side. But she is going for privacy, at least. He doesn't mind too much. He's just trying his best. And this is what will happen with antelope species. When they try and mate, is often the male will try and jump onto the back of the female. She'll keep moving forward, and when she's not ready. And eventually, she gets tired of it, and she succumbs, and eventually the mating takes place. But see, look how he's sniffing towards her genital area, so he'll be picking up the scent of her urine, and he's actually even tasting the urine so that he can work out how she's doing and if she's in heat and whether or not she's receptive to mating. But he's certainly trying his luck. Now, I know it's not the best for you, but you can see every now and then him jumping on her back, trying to be able to copulate with her. Keep trying, buddy. She'll eventually wear down and it will happen for you. Bet he wishes she was more like the leopards, in that the leopards force, the females force it on the males. I think that's what he would prefer, because he's getting really nowhere at the moment. Also, he's a very young male. You can see those horns are tiny. He's almost smaller than her as well. That's maybe why, or maybe that's why she's also moving away, is because she's thinking, well, sorry, buddy, you really aren't what I want. I want the beefcake stud of the bush, not a young upstart to be mating. But they're coming out into the open, so there we go. Oh, he's trying. No, there we go again. Paula, you want to know about Steenbok gestation. Well, first, Paula, these are not Steenbok, these are Duiker, so it's a little bit different to the Steenbok. But in terms of, oh wait, so don't worry, you did say Duiker and not Steenbok, so I will just want to double check it. But I have an idea, it's somewhere around 5 months, but I want to just make a double sure quickly. It's been a while since I've spoken about mating Duikers, so let's just check quickly. 7 months, sorry, is their gestation period. So they've got a slightly longer gestation period, 7 months, quite close to actually the impalas, which is quite strange given how small they are in relation. But that was cool. That's not something you're going to see every day. And we